All right, and welcome. Oops. Some of the stuff that worked earlier is now a little off.
Oh my. We're
Wow,
all
Emma.
over the place.
Did I go the right one?
Aha. I'm in the perfect spot.
Okay.
Oh no, I'm in Michael's. I'm Michael now.
Right. Begin explaining the game then, Michael Nessa.
So this is stealing stories for the devil, which you'd think would be about the devil, but you'd be wrong. It's about space. And as far as I can tell, the plot is like that one movie, ScarJo, I think. Who's that one white guy everyone loves? Remember they were in that movie?
Oh,
Yeah.
Chris Pratt, right?
Chris Pine, I think.
Was it Chris Pine? Oh gosh, I don't
We
know.
tend to prefer Chris Pine.
Chris
But
Pine
they're
is better, but I thought of Chris Pratt's space movie. Arrival? No, not
Oh,
Arrival. Whatever it
that was
was.
Passengers. That would have been better if it had not been Chris Pratt, because they very clearly wanted him to be kind of someone creepy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, but then all that stuff came out about Chris Pratt. So post-release, it actually works better.
Chris Pratt has infected Chris Pine with his Christmas.
Yeah, I think that's the takeaway.
Oh, I understood. Ah,
Kind of
but
like, though.
it's like that movie, but instead of love, it's all of us, and I think we do evil on each other.
No, actually, y'all are working together, so.
Oh, we're working together.
Ooh.
Yep. Am I allowed to do evil on any of them?
You're not supposed to.
Do
Okay, then
evil
we'll work
is.
together.
Why would you do evil on me?
You can do evil on Steve.
I use my evil gun on you.
I
I mean,
am
sure.
evil to you. Okay. I got those. I do not know what happened because I had those correct before. Anyway, first of all, why don't you tell us where we can find you wonderful people?
That's
We'll
it. You're
be.
closest. Yep.
I am closest and I go first on masks. So once again, I am the eldest. I'm Nessa. You can find me everywhere at right there, Loch Nessa, LochNeessa. She, her for me, and I don't know if it's she, her for whoever I'm gonna be playing. Hit me up if you want to hear about masks. It's kind of my thing that I'm talking too much about right now.
Hi, I'm Ibrahim. You can find me on the internet at cosmic underscore Eeb. You can also find me over at Prayers in the Static, which is on the Nameless Domain Twitch. I am a he him user. Those are the pronouns that I choose to equip my character with.
Hell yeah.
Hi, I'm Steve. I'm the Dragon X on TikTok and a regular here on Sundays. And that's it. I don't have anything fancy.
Right. I am Michael, he, him, and tonight we are going to be playing Stealing Stories for the Devil. Stealing Stories for the Devil is about you are a bunch of people who have been on a generation ship. And this generation ship, far in the future, went way, way out, and then something went wrong, and you have actually returned to Earth in 2023. Now, what has happened on Earth is you have essentially these like improbability zones will appear where strange things are happening. What your job is you are being sent down to go into those improbability zones, find and remove the key object that has corrupted this realm. And it's often like just a normal, almost everyday object. But this thing has created a lot of problems in that improbability zone. You grab it, you get out, and that will collapse the zone. And if any of the the players are still in there, that becomes a problem. So you have to kind of make sure that you all leave with it together. Now you are either what is called a Scion or a Sleeper. Sleepers are people who have been asleep in the cryo for the entire trip. Like you've very recently been woken up, and you still have like incredibly high-tech things inside of you. Your powers work through those high-tech things. If you're a Scion, you are someone who has been like awake on the ship, and there's been like 40 generations of people on the ship. And of course, the high-tech that people used to have implanted in their bodies. You don't have because you weren't born with it, but because of the strange cosmic radiation, you also have powers. The powers end up working the same. It's just that yours would work through your ability, like those abilities as opposed to the high tech. Now, a couple of the interesting things about this. This is designed to be a zero prep game. So basically, like, you're going to find out I wrote a sentence and I chose a map. And honestly, if we were doing this together, what I might just do is take this huge amount of maps that show up in the game. Because, like, the game box is kind of utterly packed with a bunch of two-sided maps of a bunch of different locations. So I might just throw it on the table and go, pick a place. What looks like a cool place to put this? And then we could go. Nice thing is, character creation, everything else, very simple, does not take a particularly long time. And I sent you a link, a Google Drive link, which has got some of the stuff. You won't need much of it. And some of it you can actually see on the Roll20. So for these, for starting off, in creating the characters. Oh, let me just do it real quick. Got to do that. So when it comes to creating the characters, there's a couple choices that you're going to make kind of straight off. And what you're going to find is if you either open up the one that says, or if you go into the sheets on the Google Drive, or in Roll20, I have put, there's a place with some PDFs on them. And there are three different ones there. Now these actual character sheets look like this. They're very tiny. This, you got like a reminder of some stuff here. You got a few places to put things here. And on this side, you've got like, oh, here's between like scanners and scions and a couple places to write things. You can either use like off of the Google Drive, there's like a, you can drop a, there's a form fillable one, or to be completely honest, if you just want to do this on like a sticky note or something like that, or like a, like bring up Word and just put a couple things, because the character creation is actually, there's not a lot to it.
Okay.
So to start with, you're going to choose Sleeper or Scion, and I'll just go over just the real basics of that. As I said, the Sleepers are ones who have, you've been on there, you've been asleep most of this time, so you have all sorts of super high-tech equipment, and depending on which type of thing you are, it's going to look a little bit different. The Scions are ones who have been, again, been awake for a while, but you're going to actually, we'll get the ones you choose. The Planner, Plotter, or Schemer. These are the important things, and there's three of them, which actually works well for three of us. Because of the character types, Planners use their, like, they have the ability, you each have the ability to lie to things. Now, for example, the Planner uses their senses. They lie to objects and places. For example, they can get through a locked door by just determining this lock is really old and can be broken easily. You can make alterations to physical things around you, to objects, to places. Can't affect anything outside of your sight or more than about 100 feet. Stress is partially determined by the size of the object. If it's held by someone else, their rating will fit into it. So you can't do something that would make, like, the door isn't suddenly open. But what you can do, again, like the door is not locked or the lock is easily broken, something along those lines. You can change reality in that way. The Plotter can actually change the past. They would get through a locked door by changing the past, or the person with the key forgot to lock it. So something like that had happened. So at first, you can affect about one day into the past. A person or object must affect it must be visible to you in the present. You can't affect the past of another liar, and the players are considered liars. And you can only manipulate events, not matter. Like, you can't make a car stop running, but you can make it so that they didn't fill it up, so it's about to run out of gas. Finally, the Schemer lies to people. You would get through a locked door by convincing the person with the key that it would be a good idea to open it. The target doesn't have to hear or understand the lie to have it work. But it first affects one person at a time. You can't make someone do something foolish or out of character. They're not going to, like, jump off a building. However, it's persuasion, not mind control. Must be within about 100 feet. You need to know they're there. You can't affect another liar. Animals have sort of the same limitations as humans. So in Roll20, or if you're in the Google Drive, if you look over, if you're on the where the little newspaper is for the journal, under PDFs, you can bring these up to take a look at them. There are ones for all three. And these are ones you can take a look at to decide what you want. I'm going to create real quick just some character stuff for you on here in case you want to do... Just to write the information, because there's not a whole lot you need.
All I'm seeing is cheat sheet and character creating characters.
Oh, is there one for PDFs?
Nope, no. Just
I don't see that
oh,
one.
Sorry. Oh, sorry. That will be there in a second. I forgot that. I was like, I just want to make everything open. I do. These are not things I want to hide. In a moment, some will be appearing.
Oop, there it is. All right.
How's everybody feeling?
Tentatively excited. I'm sure it will be a lot of fun, but I am not wholly sure I understand. Although it does sound like these are like the storytelling terms, like plotter, schemer, and surprise gardener isn't appearing.
Yeah, and for the most part, what you'll find is it's a heist game. It's very narrative. There's dice you're gonna end up rolling, and we'll kind of show you how that works. But overall, like, the system itself is pretty simple. These are just essentially how you can affect the world around you.
Gotcha. Okay. Is anyone leaning towards any particular one so far?
Not particularly. I'm good with any of them.
Okay. I was leaning towards Planner.
Well, looks like you're the planner.
Yeah, it's me. I lie to objects and places. Okay, so I've got that. I'll just put that here.
Steve, do you mind if I take plotter?
Go for it. I'll be the schemer.
All right, and if you want, like I said, you can either put the stuff here. I made a quick character thing for you because you're just going to be writing down a little bit of information. But if you want to get on that Google Drive, you could download. There's like a form fillable sheet, one for each. But if you want to have that.
Oh, I think the Google Drive link is going directly to a document.
Oh, let me double check that. Let me do this. Share. I will send that again. Link. Okay. I will fix that here in a moment. There we go. This will go to the folder itself and not that specific file.
Here we are. Okay. I will fill this one, I think, so I have it on the other monitor.
Next, there will be a little bit of information, and I also recommend there's one that called the reference sheet. So the reference sheet that comes with this literally has character creation on one side, like this is literally all you need, and then it's got all the rules that you need on the other. And this comes with like four of these, which is fantastic.
Perfect. Awesome. Sounds. This is Monty Cook Games. You put out a good product.
I'm definitely gonna run this at Fear the Con because this is gonna be a very easy sit down fun, like heist game.
Okay, got all my stuff open.
Okay,
all my stuff. All right. Choose if you're a sleeper or a scion. I feel like should I be just going? Just go for it.
Yeah. So yeah, the first thing you're gonna want to do. Again, if you like, choose either, you got your type, what kind of liar you are, and now just sleeper or scion. That stuff, the equipment will make a little bit of a difference, but that won't be that big a deal.
Okay, hold on. This is well written.
Awesome. The one thing I'm maybe not sold on, that while it looks great in PDF, there's so much color on this that occasionally it's not the easiest to read.
Yeah, at a distance, I can see this being difficult to parse because it kind of just looks like a blob of color.
Yeah, I will say the PDFs for like the books, there's three small books. Like, this is for the player stuff, but like most of this is like, this is the world, this is the background stuff. The GM's thing is mostly like, hey, here's how to kind of improv GM and do stuff like that. And then there's one going, hey, what kind of things happen in heists? Here's some suggestions.
Okay. I'm feeling the Scion.
I am gonna be a sleeper.
Sick.
I think I will also be a sleeper.
Okay. Quick note here. Steve, you're a sleeper witch.
Sleeper ski schemer.
Schemer deals with people.
Yeah.
All right. Ibrahim, you are a scion.
I am a Scion planner.
Okay, you deal with time.
Yep.
Nessa, you're a sleeper
Plotter.
plotter. You deal with things.
Oh wait, hold on.
Yeah, I was about to say, I thought my
Yeah,
focus was time.
we got those swapped around, sorry.
Gotcha.
Yes.
Put things on a quick sticky note. All right.
Objects and places.
Right, so once you got those, now if you look on the reference sheet, like I would recommend opening that. It is, and I've also got that on Roll 20, little small thing here. There's a list of skills. You just want to choose two, or rather, the list of traits first. You want to choose two traits that you're good at, or what you can do is spend an extra, like, pick one twice, and you're very good at that.
Oh.
That will determine how many dice you roll, or rather, I'm sorry, how, not how many, what size.
I'll take. Let's do strong and eloquent.
I am smart and charming.
Tough and entertaining.
All right, so both of all those you're good at. If you want to make a note, you have d8s on those. So if you're good, you roll a d8. For everything else, you roll a d6, unless you are bad at it, in which case it's a d4. A very good is a d10. Now, after that, there are three skills. You can choose, again, three to be good at, or you can use two of those choices to make one very good.
Okay. Let's see. These are some specific skills.
Yep.
Oh, there's a whole slew of them.
By the way, Steve, what was yours again? The ones you chose for traits?
Smart and charming.
Okay. And Ibrahim?
I mean, I work with people, so it made sense.
Ibrahim chose eloquent and strong.
Nice. And Nessa.
Tough and entertaining.
That's the that sounds like the Rodney Dangerfield special. Tough and entertaining.
We're kind of lean. I kind of immediately came up with the name Drick Dazel, and I was like, okay, this is kind of an old-timey Hollywood,
Porn
you
star
know.
name? Drick Dazel.
Drick
Drick
Dazel.
Dazel. Drick Dazel sounds like a person that was really popular in a subset of movies in Hollywood for a long time and has left the cultural consciousness entirely.
Exactly. For me, in my head, he's like a Muppet who thinks he's probably not actually a Muppet, but like he's like a Muppet who thinks he's in like a private detective movie, but like this is real life, bitch.
But yeah, you went on there. I'm like, did you used to do like those type of films or something? You come out and you're like, yeah, I'm ready. Remember, your internal monologue's supposed to be internal. Nope. Audience got to hear it.
Yeah.
Go. Oh gosh. Electronics. Do this. Think I'm gonna. The first name that came to me is Votipka. I don't know where I've read that recently,
Botica?
but yeah, Votipka. I will play Votipka.
So, are we like people or are we robots?
Nope, you are people. You're, okay. So the thing is, if you
for people with you time,
were,
right?
Yeah, since you two were sleepers, you basically like you left Earth and were gone for a long time. And when you returned, instead of you were way in the future, you got to where you thought the planet would be, and you are back on Earth in 2023, as opposed to somewhere else in the far future. And Voltika would have been raised on the ship, so you, like on the Celeste, you would have been. Like one of, I think, 40 generations that has lived on the ship itself. And because of different things you've gone through, you have these abilities. Well, they've got theirs through all their tech.
Michael, what die is it if you're really good at something? Like if you were to take something twice?
D10.
D10, okay.
I think I'll just also take
all right.
Unarmed.
That also, don't fun. Forget, I don't know if y'all guys have it, but you get the extra stealth or deception as a bonus.
Yes, correct. Yeah, you get stealth or deception you get for free.
I doubled up on deception. Yeah. I was like, he's not actually a detective, but he's good at making people think he's a detective.
I love that. I love the idea of a noir actor just being like, no, I'm a detective now.
Exactly.
All right.
Everyone's like, why wouldn't you go hire Will Smith to be a spy? He was in
some spy movie.
Are you talking about the
one where Will Smith was an animal? Like the
no,
wasn't
no, no,
that when, Will Smith as like a bird?
And I'm not talking about birds in disguise or whatever. No, I was thinking of the Secret Agent movie with the aliens.
Oh, Men in Black.
Yeah, Men in Black. He was in Men in Black. He can be a spy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Dancing, storytelling, contortion, deception.
Okay, we can do it here.
Good picks.
Okay. And do either Voltika or Drick know?
Yeah, I'm going with unarmed combat, storytelling, and machine repair.
And do you want deception or
I'm taking deception.
Okay.
I have deception, disguise. I doubled up a deception. And this should be my last one. I don't know if we're gonna need it, but I think I need the 3Ds. I think I want driving. I can be your wheel man, worst case scenario. I did all my own stunts.
So unless you've got very good, so like your deception, Nessa, you're going to have a D10. Everyone else, again, for all those, you would roll a D8.
Gotcha.
Now you pick a detriment. You have something that kind of holds you back a little bit.
I think it's slow.
Clumsy.
I just a couple hours ago was playing in a kids on bikes game where I had clumsy.
Hell yeah.
That's funny.
I'm basing. Sometimes I have to put myself into characters, and I dropped my phone in the toilet this morning. So.
Yeah. Hey, you know what? That happens. That's happened to me. It's a very unfortunate situation, but. For some reason, we decided to build toilets in a way where that's possible.
I'm going to say unhealthy.
Okay. All right. So after all of that, we are relatively close to done. A life goal. Now, if you grab the liar PDF, your detriments, if those come in, you'll be rolling a D4. On page 27,
okay.
Page 27
of the liar PDF.
Like it actually ends up being 29 rather.
I was about to say, page 27 is just a sick picture of two dudes and a lady like walking all
It's
cool.
a sick picture, though.
What it page? Is. 29.
Technically of the PDF. 29 because it's 27 in the book, but it's 29 in the PDF.
Gotcha.
You got some like cycles, examples, things like helping people, being convincing, learning, look impressive, feel adrenaline, do something new, collect valuables. Or you can come up with more, because like your side goals will be tied to one of the mission cards you might get during the mission.
Oh, okay. Get plenty of sleep isn't a good side goal. What? What are you talking about? That's a great side goal.
I don't think you understand how life works. Sleep would be amazing.
Right?
It would be. I've slept 20 hours this weekend.
You shut your mouth.
Yeah.
Woof.
Wait, yeah, no.
I wish I was you.
Friday and Saturday? I hate you.
No, I have stuff that I should have been doing. Woke up, did one errand, and I was like, I'm just going to take a little nap. And then I woke up at 7 p.m. I was just like, what happened?
That happens. That happens.
I don't nap usually. So I was like, it was concerning for me. And then I was still able to go to sleep at a normal time. Well, not normal. I went to sleep at 1. But for me, that's a normal time.
Right now, you feel like the kind of people who are like with other parents, like, oh, my child just goes straight to bed. That's how I feel about you right now. Like, oh, mine doesn't fuss at all.
If it makes you feel better, I usually gripped by insomnia.
Oh, okay. So this is a nice reprieve.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with collect valuables.
Okay. Listen, you're not stuck to the ones here. These are just possibilities.
Oh, right. No, because by default, we are liars and we tell stories and lies to people. So telling a good story is not a good side goal, I don't think. Maybe look impressive. Maybe Votipka just really wants to look cool.
Okay.
Just yoink that one. The constant struggle to look cool when girls are watching.
Hey, you think I look cool?
Hey, was that
Gamers, get out of here.
Gamers is universal, actually.
Gamers is universal.
This sexy
the gamers within.
This sexy goes across all kinds of things.
Wow. It's not enough if no one sees your greatness. I like this. This is a good side goal.
Has everyone got their side goal?
Yes, I want to help people.
Okay. So, the last thing. If you go to page 33, we've got your equipment. Now, for the sleepers, you start off with, now you'll also get, some of this stuff will be, I'll tell you where it's at in the book a little bit in a moment. And some of this you'll be able to go back and determine once you've got what the mission is. So, like, sleepers get, like, a tiny multi-tool that serves as a lockpick and a vast array of other small tools, a weapon of your choosing, body armor beneath your clothing, whatever clothing you wish, including uniforms or whatever context-appropriate attire is needed, and a contemporary smartphone. Now, once you're in the zone itself, you're unable to have any contact with the Celeste. Like, they're unable to, like, send you directly to the place. They can put you about a mile out. The Scion has tiny multi-tool that serves as a lockpick and a vast array of other small tools, weapon of their choice, body armor beneath their clothing, whatever clothing they wish, including uniforms, etc., a wrist-worn communicator and data storage device, an earpiece translator, and a contemporary smartphone. So some of those things are taken care of by stuff in the bodies of the other two.
So where would a weapon of my choice be?
Page 125 has like you start off with like the class 1 equipment. There has like some basic information. The stuff you have would all work like would all be kind of considered normal in like in the modern day. Like you're not necessarily going to have like laser blasters and stuff like that.
Roger Dodger.
Right.
Let's see. That stuff. Probably just going to be a gun.
Okay.
Let's see. What is that all got?
I hope it's not too that, but I also gun.
That stuff's fine. There's not like a shopping list of like here all the different types of things.
Oh wait, hold on. Sorry, am I misunderstood? Wait.
Last one, equipment. I don't see weapons anywhere.
Yeah, I'm seeing like heavy toolkit, internet tap.
Maybe scroll up weapons? A little bit.
Okay.
Because I saw weapons on 121.
On 121. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it doesn't, really doesn't matter what weapon. Yeah. You use the mechanical terms, okay. The skills matter. The fight is portrayed as a scene, not blow by blow or shot by shot. Different weapons have different narrative qualities. Some might be silent, some might be really good at getting through barriers, etc. A few of the really advanced ones in this chapter might offer harmony. If you played for a bit, you can advance your character. Weapons more sophisticated than knife are usually DNA coded, so that only a specific individual or individuals can make use of them. Don't track ammunition or standard ranges. So basically, you can kind of just come up with whatever you need.
Okay. Well, then I'm thinking of the cooler weapon than a gun. What's cooler than a gun? Nunchucks. It's nunchucks.
Nunchucks are pretty cool.
Nunchucks are cool. High risk, high reward. You can look really cool or really not.
Yeah, punk. Ow. Ow.
I feel like I want a katana.
It for some of this, it may help to know kind of where you're going. And if you've got at least that stuff, are we ready to move over to the briefing part?
Let me write down the rest of my.
Okay. It's made up of three acts. The first act is you get here's the mission, here's the place you're going, and what happens is you come up with your plan of action. So if you had played Wilderness of Mirrors, it's kind of like that, and I'll be able to go kind of a yes and or a yes but. Through there, adding in complications, and then you'll have here's the plan, and that may make a difference in what weapons or other stuff you get. And then as you go in to do it, that's when we see, you know, kind of all the various things happen. And actually, I'm also going to deal you in roll 20. Each of you are going to get three mission cards. These are cards that you can play to make things happen. And they'll each have some special things for you. I have, you've got the mission cards. I have twist cards. And this is one where if we're playing multiple stories, you add up all the cards that were used, and then those become, between both you and the GM, those become points that essentially you can use to buy advancements. So I have like six of them with a turn on or twist on them. So I can throw these down on the table and go, but here's a twist. Here's what makes this thing more difficult. And I have one thing for the turn, which usually starts act three. This is where something that seemed like it was one way turns into something else. So you've all got those, and I'm going to move you over to our briefing page.
Ooh!
You are brought on the Celeste. You're all called in one of the briefing rooms, and Celeste's AI lets you know, just like you, like on the board in front of you, like rises up from the like the hologram. There is a cruise ship on an ocean that you can see on there, and you're actually able to like kind of look deck by deck, and the information that comes up, this is the Golden Iris. On it, there is a breakup letter that is handwritten, and this has become the key object of this improbability zone. Currently, and things can get worse in the improbability zone, people are more prone to argument or violence. This breakup letter has infected the crew and the people there, and if it is allowed to continue, will have much greater effects in reality. We do not know who has the breakup letter. We do not know where it is at. This is your mission. We'll be able to drop you about a mile on a boat with a motor, and you'll be able to make your way to the ship.
Sounds like Ben.
All right, so we have got our cruise ship. And we've got, like I said, you've got like casino, the sun deck, you've got base deck, main deck, activity deck, lounge deck, top deck. These are where all the things are. So what you get to start doing, talking amongst each other, making your plan, and then I will be putting the plan onto the board and then kind of letting you know, okay, we're going to, like, yes, but here's a complication that will go along with the things that you're looking at.
I'm going to go get some food in me, and I'm going to be smarter in about 30 seconds.
Okay.
Understood.
So I'm going to refill my drink while you do that. I'll be right back.
All right. Well, I'm going to be back in a moment as well.
And I will sit here and entertain the troops. How's everybody feeling tonight? Anyone from Chicago? Anyone from Chicago out in the crowd? Crowd work. I'm wondering if I can do a mid-Atlantic accent.
Old-timey movie stars?
You see, the picture's not for sale. What I want is a job, no?
Wasn't for sale to you. It was never going to be for sale for you. That was something my father had for me and for the rest of the boys.
It's not about you and the boys. See, this thing's like...
We don't even hear it that much anymore. You got to go back to old movies really for that.
Oh, I have the Shakedown 1950 Howard Duff, Lawrence Tierney, and Ann Vernon playing in the background at the moment.
Have you ever watched The Thin Man?
I don't think so.
Surprisingly modern dialogue, like the husband-wife detective team, like their banter is incredible.
Ooh. Ooh. She has something that my grandpa was really obsessed with old movies. Like he just watched them all day, every day.
Let's be honest, they weren't old movies to your grandpa. They were just movies.
Yeah, they were. He'd sit down and he'd be like, I saw this one back in the day, you know, for 5 cents at the picture show. And I'd be like, Grandpa, did you go to the picture show every single goddamn day? And he was like, yes.
You used to watch the serials before.
He was like, yep. It was the only building in Brooklyn with air conditioning. Of course I was there every fucking day.
Oh, God.
That makes sense.
I'd imagine before air conditioning was really common, that was actually not probably an unusual thing on hot days.
Yeah. I mean, even pre-air conditioning, he was just big movie guy.
They got air conditioning. Everyone started showing up. I'm like, no, see, this is my place. You're coming in here for the air conditioning. I'm here for the art, damn it. Steve, do you have a name in mind?
Kivar.
What?
K-I-V-A-R. Kivar.
Like Kivar?
Yeah, Kivar.
Gotcha.
I haven't used that name in a while, so I'm going to use it again.
One of my aliases.
I got Drick from the futuristic name generator. It was between Axton, Landon, Aiden, but spelled all messed up. Finnegan, also spelled all messed up.
I don't know how futuristic that is anymore.
I mean, maybe it's supposed to be pronounced Adon, but my brain is just filling in Aiden. Ace, also spelled wrong. Drick, Matston, Darren, Eric, or Eric's, and then Len.
There's something like Linane that's like an Irish name.
I should know that probably. This is on my relatives for not choosing more interesting names.
Damn them to hell.
Damn.
Oh, Did I do it? I did this. I went to visit my mom to hang out with my old roommate, and her daughter comes up at one point and just kind of goes over and goes, "Why is Uncle Michael here?" we're watching Blacklist, and she goes up and whispers in her ear, and she just goes, "Well, why don't we wait till your dad's home? Because he'll want to be here too for that." It goes like later on when Mike got home and brought some food and such. She once again, she's like, "Well, we're not quite finished with this, but we'll watch it after that." Mike had taught her sound editing. And she made this, like, they made this little video. She's, like, 7. And it's her just going, welcome to the Fartradome! And then there's this, like, huge sound of a fart that breaks glass, and then, like, a bunch of other farts after it. She was very excited for me to see that.
You know what? That is an after-dinner, after-dessert, theatrical, spectacular.
Have that little gelato while you're watching.
Yeah. It's time for coffee and the fart, the fartacular?
The Fartradome?
Fartradome.
Apparently, she told him, God, Dad, stop being so supportive. It's so cringe.
Aw, Seven's too young to be cringe. Or to say cringe. Oh, actually, that's not true. My favorite
thing.
What
is happening to this country?
Yeah, I was about to say that, but also my favorite thing in the world was to say when I was seven was stupid. Wasn't allowed, but that's why I always said it. I was just like, try and stop me. You can't.
It's already been said.
What are you going to do? Take something away from me? I'm a child. I have nothing.
All right. So you're going to start on a small motorboat a mile away from where this currently is at sea.
I know who's driving the boat.
It's just like a car.
Yeah.
But it's a boat.
Just like a car. Okay, yeah. Yeah, it's pretty close, right?
Look, this is one of those things. I've crashed several ACVs. This is not one. In one way, Drix and I are separate.
How do you spell caviar again?
Kivar.
Kivar?
K-I-V-A-R.
Okay.
I have it spelled K-E-V-A-R on my thing, just because phonetic.
So Kivar will drive the boat.
Oh no, Ness's character has driving.
Oh,
Drix. Drix Dazel is driving this boat.
Drix will drive the boat. And what happened? That's the one thing I wish this would do is... Okay. All right, so you now get to come up with your plan. Remember, basically imagine the thing you don't know is exactly where it's at. But you are professionals. As you come up with a plan, this is the thing that will go. Also, whenever you lie to something, it will work. The only thing that happens is you have to try to you have to roll to see if you get stressed. Now, that's going to depend on kind of maybe how big it is, how long in the past. There's this idea of the verisimilitude. Like, does what you're doing make some sense just naturally? Like, is this something that feels like, yes, this could be something that's possible? And then the scope. Like, how believable is this, and how hard is it to lie about it? So, if you get stress or injured, you get an injury dice. Injury dice is a D10 that has one side has the X on it. That injury dice you roll, if it ever comes up that way, you have failed in what you've done. You can't have multiple injury dice. So what you want to do is decide what is your plan?
By the way, are either of you women or are you both men or non-binary?
I'm a guy.
I think Votipka is non-binary. Probably, I don't know, just kind of like really, what's the word? Androgynous.
Okay. Do you go by they, them?
Sure. Yeah, we'll do that. Yeah, that makes sense. Mm-hmm.
Well, I was about to say fellas, so that's, we're going to change that too. All right, gang. What's the plan? How are we getting on this cruise ship?
I think that we should we drive boat into ship, climb up ladder. Simple.
The seas themselves are a bit rough. They're going to be rough and choppy. But yeah, beyond that, fairly straightforward.
Now, I'm not looking to be a bimbo, but I don't think that crashing the boat into the side of the ship is going to do it. Otherwise, we might end up all wet.
I think we can get up the side of the boat. It'll be fine.
Oh, the side of the boat. I thought you were saying you wanted to crash it into the side of the boat.
No, climb ladder. No, ladder on side of boat.
Oh, okay.
We'd sink the boat.
Need
Why
boat.
Would we sink? We'd sink the boat after. Yeah.
All right. Now, do we want to put on any kind of disguises? Dress up like blue noses or something?
Maybe. Ooh. What if we put on disguise as if we are survivors of boat crash? They pick us up.
I think we can sneak on, but once we are on, I just want us to look less like less like your regular old breezers and more like ship people. Real Debs and Dolls.
Suit not work?
Yeah, okay.
So what do you want to go with there?
Wear
Yeah, where are we?
suits.
Wear
Wear
suits.
suits and say we're part of the staff.
Okay. That and we're just coming if anyone sees us coming up.
Okay.
And if anyone sees us?
They requested more help, so they sent us on a boat to catch up to the boat, and now we're here to help. Like,
Yeah.
don't overthink it.
This
Okay.
makes sense. I like it.
For that one, if you're the help, you'll have to get on their rosters with their information, because it's a little unusual to come out in the middle of it. But that can give you access to other things.
All right. I think I'll try to. I'll like as I'm driving, start to like because I can affect up to the day. So let's hope there's like a I can either change the roster at the beginning of the day or like send out a memo like, hey, sending some extra people to try to get us included. Now, how do I do that
Oh, no. All you're
specifically?
doing right now is planning.
Oh,
Yeah,
okay.
this whole thing is just the plan, because like you're going through, you're planning on what to do, and then you'll go through. Yeah, biggest thing is you have to like see the person or the thing, so you have to find who that memo would go to. Can you see this while I'm typing or on a roll 20 over on the side? I put a text box in there. Okay, I don't know if you can see while I'm typing. All right. So yeah,
Oh,
so
why,
we,
I think it appears at the end of the
Oh,
line.
yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so what you're going to want to do is, so at this point the plan is you're basically setting up the plan. I'll give some of the things that'll happen, and ideally you're able to go through the plan, but as things go wrong, you're going to have to improvise. Right, then what? If you're planning on this, it'll get you on board the ship. Remember, you got the map of the ship if you want to find things. For the most part, things that you need, you'll be able to like find. I may just put like what makes it difficult or like where you have to go for it or something along those lines.
Just checking something really quick.
So we're trying to find some dame or doll who was left holding the bag in their relationship, right? And find a letter that connects that.
That is
They'll...
my understanding.
Yeah, you basically want the key object, which is almost always just a normal everyday object. Once you get that off, like out of the zone, it'll collapse the zone and turn everything. Anybody who dies will remain dead, which could be a problem for the future. That you want to be
Oh, we're
careful
gonna
of.
kill people.
Oh,
Oh,
no.
okay. Well,
If you happen to kill someone, it could be a problem in the future. So that's why you want
they will not come
like.
back to life. Huh.
Correct.
Okay. When we get on board, I will go to VIP rooms on top deck. Search VIP rooms, look for letter.
Are we sure whoever this person is a VIP?
Do not know.
Okay.
Good start.
It is a good start.
I work from top deck down.
Yeah, I was gonna say
We want to split up.
the problems for some of that'll be just finding the person will be the problem there. Like finding like someone who might have a letter like that.
What if we put up some kind of like heartbreak dance on the casino or something for anyone out there, all those lonely souls.
It could work. Little dance, get everyone in the same area. Maybe see if someone doesn't show up because they're already heartbroken.
Okay, and I'll say that the thing for this, a heartbreak dance or something, will not really bring the VIPs there, but we'll get others there.
So
Though
why
the
don't
Volt, yeah,
you?
you were talking about going to the VIP room anyway.
Yeah, I guess I need to make sure they're not in their rooms. But they're probably VIPs on a cruise ship. I think they're going to be out, right? I've never been on a cruise. I don't know what that.
They might be out, but the thing is, like, they're not necessarily going to be mixing with. There's some places where the
common folk,
yeah, where the rich, like some of the people who are not like the really wealthy, will probably be down in the like would make up to like a heartbreak dance.
Party is good idea, good distraction.
Okay.
What else? We have many, many people to search through.
We could access the itinerary and see who doesn't have anyone with them in a room. A person who's heartbroken wouldn't be by themselves, wouldn't you think?
Good idea. Itinerary. I don't see like an office. Oh, there's a lobby. Maybe the office is next to the lobby. Do boats have offices?
Oh yeah, there's good people around. You've also got like
the captain would have a manifest. I can line my way into that.
Oh, also yes, it might be a slinker of an idea. That doesn't mean anything. That means donut. It might be a slinker of an idea to check the manifest to see who came on as a couple and is now not hanging out with one another.
Okay. Yeah, I think... Oh, excuse me. So, Drick's heartbreak dance. Me, search VIP rooms. Perhaps Case Casino. Or look for VIPs around and try and get information if I can. And you will be doing the searching for the manifest.
Yeah. I'll find the manifest, one way or another. Captain probably keeps it in his quarters or in the cockpit, whatever they call that on a ship, the helm.
I do know because I follow a captain on TikTok. We'll actually take you through. The captain's room is basically directly off of the bridge.
Okay. The captain gets to go to bed first.
Unless you're on one of those tiny yachts.
Fair. This looks pretty big. This is a proper cruise.
One of those big ass cruise liners.
This is the Joko cruise. Brennan Lee Mulligan's on here.
Somewhere.
Erica Ishii's on here. Sounds like good plan.
Okay.
Nifty. I guess that's probably right at the time that I like let up on the gas because we're here.
Well, no. This is before you're teleported down.
Oh, before we're teleported down. Okay.
Yeah, this is while you're on the thing. You come up with a plan. What other things are you thinking?
We will have to meet up somewhere. Meet up on Sundeck to an hour after landing? Or what's our time limit?
About a day.
One? About a day?
Like things will continue to get worse and weird there.
Perhaps 1 hour after we... Is 1 hour enough time for everyone to do a preliminary check or longer?
2 hours?
Two.
2 hours, team meets up and we figure out what we're doing.
Meet up in the gym on the activity deck and go from there.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
So we'll go with that?
Yep. Yep.
All right.
Good plan, everyone. Good plan. Slapping everyone on the back.
Okay, so a few things. Do any of you show like some macros down at the bottom, like D4, D8, D6, etc., and injury dice? If you go over to the macros, which is the bullet list over on Roll 20.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
If you go there and you'll see a thing where it says show macro quick bar, and you'll notice injury dice, and then it's got like all the dice. They didn't put them in order because of, you know, whatever. But like however you click those for in bar, that'll be how they show up at the bottom.
I clicked on it and like all the names went up a little bit, but there's nothing there.
Well, what did you
click? Yeah, I'm checking.
Show macro quick bar?
Yeah.
But then you have to click for each of those to put them in the bar. Because there could technically be a ton of stuff there, because certain players may need certain like macros in there where others don't.
So how do I add those in?
There should be a little in bar over on the right.
Oh, untitled.
In bar. Hold on. I see.
Oh, wait.
I'm wondering if it's just off my screen.
How does this not show up for everybody?
All I see is untitled.
I don't see that. Yeah. I see a rollable table that has some stuff in it, but.
And not, up top, there's not like a thing for macro.
I mean, I also have checked show macro quick bar.
Okay, so but right above that, there's that. Not new macros not showing in quick bar to players. Not showing refresh the screen, turn the macros off. Let's see what they say. Edit macro screen upon scroll down the bottom. The show to players is what the is hidden by default. What?
Oh, the useful.
That makes sense.
Oh, that car.
Leave it to roll 20.
I mean, that's one of those things like, yeah, occasionally you're not going to want. So, yeah, they should start populating.
There we go.
Now, in the third
act. Are you having to go through and do them one by one?
Yeah, it doesn't take too long. That should be at the top. Like, that should be in a place you see. So, right now, do you have D4 to D20 and then an injury die?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just going to recheck them in order.
Yeah. Do we need a D20?
It's possible, though unlikely to get there. Okay. Especially like in the third act, everything goes up one step level. Hmm. If something's already at a D12, for example, it'll step up to D20. That's about the highest you can get. I don't think we'll have a lot as far as with new characters. So when you actually roll, what you have is. Put it here. You've essentially got like this, like easy, average, blah 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 blah, and there is a hurdle, like 1 to 2, 3 to 4, 5 to 6, 7 to 8, etc. Now, what happens on those? You can actually bring this up on the little thing. If you get in the hurdle that like those two things, that is like an almost. You almost succeeded, but you may need to do something else. If you get above the hurdle. You've succeeded. If you get double whatever the hurdle is, you have like a success. And if you get below the hurdle, that's a failure. If you roll a 1, that is like a failure and, essentially.
Okay.
So in the third act, everything changes. So instead of there being two numbers in the hurdle, like a hard is a 5 or a 6, it will just become 6. So basically a 1 to 5 will fail. A 6 is an almost. And a 7 or above is a success, for example, for something that's hard. And for pretty much all your rolls, that's how it'll work. And I'll let you know kind of what level those are. And then if you have to roll, like for injuries, you roll to basically see if you can kind of soak the injury, essentially, or the stress.
Okay. Do we have any... Do we have any modifiers or like exploding dice?
So the modifiers you can you can get assistance. If you get help from someone, what happens is they'll give you their die. If equipment or circumstances helps out, you get to roll the die twice and take the better one. And sometimes some of your cards will give you like a boost, which will raise it up by 1, by basically raise the die size up by 1. And in the third act after the turn. All the die sizes are up by 1. Things are a little more desperate. It's a little hard. Like there's a little bit more chance of failure, but you are a bit better at those things at that point.
Perfect.
All right. Any questions before we kind of teleport you about a mile away?
Mm-mm.
Prepared.
All right.
I will admit I never found the thing that I need to click to see the bar.
So over at the top, you know how you've got the thing at the side that's got like the journal, etc.
Yes.
And a dice roll. So there's one that's called collection. It looks like a bulleted list.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah. And if you hit show macro quick bar.
Great. There we go.
I really wish you could just basically go, just show this automatically to players.
Right. And just set it per game.
Certain things.
I was looking at my settings.
Yeah. So yeah, then if you go through, you can put all the dice down there. Like there's another way. You can also pull dice off of the little bar thing there and set it up. It's just a little bit easier just to click. Cause we're not usually, if we'll need more than one die, you can just kind of just click, click, click. You'll be good.
So, wonderful. All right. I'm ready to go.
And you also notice on the character sheets, they give you, like, here's what it looks like when you use your abilities. Everything else will look relatively normal. For our two sleepers, you have in you, like, a bunch of, like your automatic translation. So, like, you understand English or whatever language someone is speaking at this current time. You're also able to speak that way. For the Cyan, you've got, like, the earpiece that allows you to understand. The translation, though, let me just double check on that. Devil. So on the actual translators, earpiece translator, it's in the ear in any known language so the wearer can understand. You can understand, but you don't necessarily, you can't necessarily talk. To everybody. There may be some people whose language you do not understand. For everyone else, the cybernetic implants, oh yeah, fits in the ear, it'll translate for anybody.
Wonderful.
All right. Okay, so you get into the boat, it teleports you down, and you are suddenly on kind of very choppy seas. You know the direction, but right now you are looking out across a huge expanse of what is going to be dark before too long. You can kind of see some of the stacks from way the hell out there. And you are now on those choppy seas. Who's driving?
Drix.
All right, Drix. I'm going to need you to make a roll for this as you go, basically to see if y'all get buffeted around and maybe injured a little bit on the way in, because this is not an area of the sea where you want to be on a smaller, like, motorboat.
Damn.
You were looking at a hard one. Now, so on the way there, you're
Fellas, it's a lot different from a car.
You're going to make it there. However, what I'll need everyone to do, and this is, now if you've got something like as far as toughness, which I think someone does, or something along those lines, what we're doing is, or something you have that you think you could make an argument that it would allow you to maybe not get tossed around into things and take some injury. What I'm going to have you do is, we'll say, make a roll against an average. You're looking at a three or four. Basically, you want to give above a four.
Would contortionist be
good? No. The contortionists I know are, well, kind of strong. They're also smaller and will be probably thrown around a lot more by something like this.
That was worth a shot. So it's a D6, right?
Yep.
Can I use tough to get out of this?
No, it won't get out of it. But the thing is, what that'll let you do is roll with a D8 instead of a D6. Damn. Oh.
So seeing how I'm unhealthy, would that put me at a D4?
Roll a D4. Roll a D4.
I guess I should ask. Is strong good enough to use? Yeah. Yeah, okay, I can just hold on to the boat.
Just go, poof, just grab there in like a doorway.
You said it was normal, so average?
No, so on this one's hard. So, yeah, Steve, you've got an injury. Nessa, you also have an injury.
So roll the injury die?
No, basically it just means when you roll, you'll also be rolling an injury die.
Oh, and that's subtracted from your roll?
It doesn't subtract from the roll. What the injury die will do, so you'll see if I hit it, it'll say nothing, nothing, nothing. One of those, one out of the 10 is an X. Good lord.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
Injury.
Oh, there, I saw it.
Yeah, oh.
There it is.
Yeah, so like basically one out of 10. You can get multiple injury dice. So I would just make a note right now. What happens is you are on your way, if you want to describe what happens as you're trying to go over these rough waves towards the ship.
I mean, I just imagine that I'm not really doing a good job as driving, and you two are just like, whoa!
Yeah. Why are we doing this? Why is the boat moving so much? Hold the boat steady. Hold yourself steady.
About a clam for every person who told me to do that.
You told me you could drive. What are you doing?
Hey, what am I, some kind of big cheese? I can drive just fine.
I'm going to have a concussion by the time we get there.
And you can see as you're kind of getting closer to, there's people on, there's like basically the entire, there's like a huge amount of people like on that side of the ship. Just as one person noticed this boat coming, and there's a section of the ship that actually drops down. A fun fact, when I went on a cruise with my parents and well, my whole family when I was like right after college, because they wanted both my sister and I to go on this thing. And my whole thing was I wanted to go to like the Mayan ruins. When we're supposed to get out, there's the thing that opens up and like the boat can kind of come here. And we saw that boat that was there. Like let's say this is the place we can see through. We just watched the boat go. Like the little boat we were supposed to get on came in the thing and went away, and then came up into the thing and then went away because the waves were so bad we couldn't leave the ship.
Oh yeah. When I was on vacation in Greece, there was this really rich Russian oil guy, and he had this big, huge black yacht. Mm-hmm. And at one point, it opened up, and a little baby yacht came out, like the big yacht was giving birth to it. And it was still a huge little yacht. It just came out of a bigger yacht, so it seemed tiny by comparison.
Launch the smaller yacht!
I don't know how it gets back up in there, though. Not gonna lie.
Yeah. So as this happens, like it kind of opens up. You like that part opens up, and you see this like armature, kind of make its way out and into place. And there's a bunch of the crew that are down there as you kind of come up alongside the ship, and it lowers down. It lowers down some of these chains and a platform underneath. Which I don't know if that's how it works, but anyway. But then as it grabs the boat and then brings it up, they can swing it in. There's a bunch of people there as it kind of swings the boat in and into the thing. The captain, who's like tall and kind of stately, and she comes up as you're there and goes, "What the fuck is going on? Why are you out at sea in this kind of a boat this far out?"
"We were sent to help. You sent a message saying you needed a couple more people, and here we are. They told us to get in the little dinghy and go."
"I don't remember sending
out
a message.
Did you not get the memo from corporate?" And then, I guess, can I, like...
"Are you using your lying?"
I thought this is, yes, my lying.
Yeah, but basically, like, the lie, yeah. So basically, you could make, that if she's the one who would have got the memo, then basically you could go, "Oh, yeah, she got a memo." So what will happen is this will automatically work. What you're trying to do is see about stress. So I'm going to say, well, a memo, something wouldn't be unusual. Sending someone out this far is going to be, I'm going to make that a hard, just because it's you don't send people out usually on a boat which you're on for extra help. If they have to have something like that, it might be a helicopter. So just you've like a 5 or a 6 is sort of the almost, the 7 or above.
And what dice would this be?
So probably your deception. Your deception, though, is very good. So that for you.
Oh, thank D8. God. D10.
Or D10, rather.
I think so, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think so. You put 2 in.
Yeah, D10.
And then roll your injury dice along with it.
Although, to be fair, we haven't been doing so well.
I've been doing fine.
Okay, as you do this, the stress...
Where are my good rolls, Michael? You know me.
I'm gonna say the stress on this one is going to be average. So you're looking at a 3 to 4 that you are trying to fight as far as do you get another injury on there?
Sorry, what do I do to see how my stress is doing?
Oh, I'm sorry, let me check one thing real quick.
Do you maybe have something in your deck that could help you out here?
I mean, we're already using my deception. Is like an item or like a skill?
Well, like the mission deck things have like the deception is a skill, But the mission deck things, I don't know what y'all have, but like I have some pretty nifty ones.
Mine not are helpful here. Mine are garbage.
Oh dang.
Garbage.
Well, I already forgot to use one that would have been helpful for y'all, so we'll just ignore that.
Okay.
I think I can swing this, Daddy-o.
Actually, let me tell you. I think when you tell the lie,
wrong time frame.
Yeah. So I think let me just double check this real quick. The stress of telling a lie changes everything. Is necessarily more difficult to resist, but it creates potently more injury. In other words, a liar has to make two. Yeah, so make a note that, like, as you do it, like, you feel kind of the stress shift inside of you on there. So you can basically take you'll have a second injury die that you'll be rolling when you roll stuff.
For the lies, can I use one of my thingies, or is it too early?
One of your mission cards?
Yes.
Yeah, you can.
Okay, I'm better than you think. Turn any failure into an almost, or an almost into success. Because yeah. 2 is pretty bad, right?
Oh, yeah. Two is not great. I do believe... let me check what I wrote on my cheat sheet. Essentially, almost... Oh, almost count as... Well, if almost do not count as successes for if you're trying to get rid of strain.
Will an almost make whatever...
Oh, no, no, no.
We're about to enter less.
It always works. It's just, do you take stress from it? So a lie will always work. A capital L lie will always work. It's just you roll up for stress.
All right. Well, okay. Then 2 injury dice for old Rick.
Yeah. Since like, it's one of those things where, like, that's a kind of lie that's a little harder to take. It's going to work, but as you kind of feel the stress kind of hit, there's this moment where she goes, oh, yes, of course. For some of the next couple days. Let's see you to some quarters. Make sure. Are you all okay?
We are fine. We are just a little bit banged up. If you have some ibuprofen and perhaps some bandages.
Yeah. They kind of look like it. We'll get you with the doc.
Okay. Some Flintstones chewable morphine would be good.
I'm dandy doll, and then I throw up over the side of the ship.
Yeah, Blake Godfrey,
does this all the time.
The doctor kind of grabs you, and takes you in. Gives you some ibuprofen if you've been kind of banged up a little bit. Like, we'll put a bandage on you if you need it. It's nothing that will mechanically help you, but kind of brings you in and kind of goes through and just goes, I don't know what the hell they were thinking, sending all of you on a ship in this kind of ocean. I mean, my God, it should have at least been a helicopter.
I know, it's ridiculous. They're scrimping and saving. So cheap.
It's a miracle you weren't killed.
Yes, we are going to go do some things now to help you around the ship. I am going to change out of these wet clothes and then begin attending to the VIPs.
Yeah, just a moment. And then kind of goes out and... this is Hakeem, opens the door. Hakeem Okafor. He's the head of staff, and Hakeem kind of looks over the three of you and goes, I'll show you to your rooms.
Okay.
Kind of comes through and takes you down into the staff area. The staff area is going to be on the kind of the base deck. Y'all stay a bit deeper than most other people. Well, thankfully for all of you, we had a number of rooms that did not have any, that were open for other staff that we did not hire. So, and it kind of shows you to like three of the rooms in the back of the base deck. And goes, if you want to grab stuff from your own boat, you'll be able to grab that and bring it here.
Yeah.
Excellent.
I just put a little thing around it. Those will be your rooms.
Perfect.
All right, we'll put you on the schedule for tomorrow.
All right.
Yes, thank you very much, Hakeem. Well, I'm going to change now, if you would like to leave.
Yeah. I assume you go and get, like, clothes and other stuff off of the boat.
Yeah.
Okay. And like,
yeah, change it to like a dapper pinstriped suit, a little bit of zoot suit action going on. Unless we have uniforms, we probably have uniforms.
I'm assuming you.
I'm like pulling the zoot suit out of my bag of disguises.
Technically, we should have talked about what the stuff you wanted to bring in the planning, but we'll go ahead and allow that.
I mean, if there's a uniform, I'll just wear that.
Yep.
But
I'm sure it's a suit.
Do they wear suit? I thought they had polos on cruise liners.
I think it kind of depends on where you're at. I've been on one and it was a long time ago. I remember like when we went to like the restaurant, they were all like fancy, but everyone else was dressed much more casually, but you could always tell who was who worked on the ship.
Gotcha.
Hmm.
Got little hats on.
Plus it could be like a Gatsby themed cruise.
Oh yeah. What year are we in? Do we know?
2023.
Oh, okay. Cool. So I have a modern smartphone. I pull out my S22.
Yep. No signal where you're at.
Damn. No hotspot on the ship?
There are places you can go, but you got to pay for it.
No.
Ugh. Woof. No. Cruises become less appealing by the moment. If it wasn't for the apparent dens of disease that they are, the no Wi-Fi hotspot, that unforgivable.
Exactly. You gotta wait till you get in. You get towards like shore or something, where you can pay to send sort of everything at once, because it gets real expensive to get Wi-Fi on a ship back to the land.
I guess so. All right. Well, we have our plans. Do we need to consult with Hakeem for anything, or?
That'll put us on the schedule tomorrow, so I assume we're good for tonight to do whatever we want.
Yeah.
I mean, keen to get a wiggle on, but I don't know if necessarily that they're going to be all ducky about me putting on a heartbreak dance.
Were you frozen in the 1920s? Is that what this is?
Yes.
You went to sleep directly from the roaring 20s? I'm picking up a little bit of a theme here.
It's a cruise ship. They have dances every night.
Yes, yeah, but
a theme dance that I run.
Work on that. We will have other things to do.
And also, I was one of the first people ever frozen. I fell into a vat of chemicals.
Like the Joker.
Like the Joker.
From the movie Joker?
No.
Movie Joker.
No, from the good one, the better one with Jack Nicholson.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
More like Mr. Freeze is his wife.
I always liked Mr. Freeze's wife. I saw that in the archives many times. I believe that was one of the great pieces of cinema that was saved when we had to be frozen and go on this journey, this long journey. It was only that and Indiana Jones 5. The one with the young Indiana Jones.
Oh, that was 4.
That was 4. Oh, yeah, that one.
Yeah, 5.
Actually, no, the sequel with the young Indiana Jones' son, and then with the AI CGI version of Indiana.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Anyways, right.
What do you do?
Did they save the upturned glass with James Mason and Pamela Keelio?
I don't know what that.
It's a classic.
I've never heard of that. I'm going to go.
A movie from 1957.
Yeah, if it's not, I'm going to go to the VIP rooms. I'm going to go root around in their stuff.
We will meet back here in 2 hours.
Meet back here in 2 hours. We have rooms now. No reason to go to gym.
Okay.
Don't take any wooden nickels.
All right. Voltika, you're heading up the VIP room. Where's Kevar heading?
He is... I guess he's going to try to get to the captain's quarters to get the manifest.
Okay. And for drinks.
I guess I'll head to the bar, the patio bar and lounge to see if, you know.
Okay. The patio bar, yeah, so on the lounge deck. Yeah, let's we'll kind of start with you then, because you have got the kind of closest to go, because off of the casino and such, you'll have like the VIP rooms, or do we have those elsewhere on here? Yeah, they're up on the top deck. So there's just an atmosphere as you're going through. You know that in probability zones, sometimes very strange things happen. But here, like as you're kind of going up there, you can hear the sounds of a fight down one hall. People arguing, you hear a door slam. Like everything just feels sort of extremely tense as you kind of come up. The patio bar and lounge. As you sort of head there, you kind of go around the... there's like the restaurant that's in there, and you can hear someone arguing, some Karen asking for the manager. And the patio bar and lounge, there's some people grabbing some hot dogs and such, but like hot dogs and hamburgers, those things are kind of constantly going. You've got a few people swimming, but overall, like around this area, you have a lot of people kind of keeping to themselves a bit here.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they're not even fun sad. They're regular sad. I could deal with it if they wanted to drink away their sorrows. All right, I guess I'll go try to eavesdrop on the yelling.
Okay. Oh, in the bar?
Yeah, in the bar.
Okay,
anything noticeable or just a normal yelling? You kind of
head over towards like the restaurant. There's a woman who gets up and she actually just like kind of throws the stuff, and you see a guy about 24 maybe, who's there. Is like I'm sorry if it wasn't something you like. She's this is done. Literally throws it to the ground. And it's getting in his face. You see a manager come up and actually like step in between them and push her back just a little bit. Like doesn't get kind of quite in her face. And there's just this moment where you see the guy behind the manager is just sort of like wide-eyed, sort of looking anywhere like to get out of this place right now.
I guess I'll run up to like not run up, but I'll like slide up to Nick. Next up to that guy and be like, hey, young fish, you want to get a wiggle on?
She takes a look at you and says, what? Wait.
You want to get out of here?
Yes. And just kind of looks as the manager's going. He goes, yeah, I'm going to take a smoke break. And then the manager's like, yeah, just get out. And he's like, he's arguing. This lady doesn't like the food. And then you hear the guy's like, these were made by chefs who've worked in Michelin star, like yelling kind of back and forth as you sort of go out onto the deck where you've got the breeze sort of like hitting again. And the guy just kind of gets out there, pulls out a cigarette, and
now what got that? Now what got that Flivver's gams in a tangle?
Okay. She's pissed off the minute, I mean, everyone's, I don't know why everyone's on edge, but pissed off the minute I got there and didn't like anything. Like, everything was wrong. Just, like, it wanted everything made really super special. Like, my manager was already pissed at her when she sent two or three things back and then just had it, I guess. Nothing was good enough.
Mm-hmm. Is everyone, I just got here, is everyone on the ship a real fire extinguisher?
It's a weird trip. Everyone just seems pissed.
Well, I mean, I think I might know how to take the edge off.
That would be.
You think the manager would let them start happy hour a little early?
I don't know if he's got the ability to do that. You can ask him. It ain't gonna hurt. All right.
You okay, Jake?
Oh, Chiato.
Ah.
You are, You
Drick.
are... Drick?
Huh. A normal name.
Where are you from, Drick?
New York City.
Virgin Islands.
The sea's a wonderful place.
All right. Let us pop over to Ibrahim. VIP lounge. You sort of you head that way. Go past the casino. Make your way in. And there are, like I said, there's a lounge there right as you sort of come in. And in there you have, you can kind of smell a bit of some weed coming through. There's also a bunch of like cigarettes, cigars, and other stuff, and lots of clinks of glasses. You walk in, there's just a lot of people kind of hanging out. Again, some people, there's some arguing in the corner. You've got some people who are like just sort of sitting very coldly at their tables. And then like a couple waiters that are like headed back and forth serving people.
Okay. Yeah, I'll if there's like somebody walking by with a glass, like with a mimosa or something, I'll grab that and just sip it and be like, I could get used to this.
As you grab it and slip it, there's just a moment where she looks at you and goes, I'm sorry, do you have a VIP badge?
No, I work here.
You're not supposed to be, yeah, you're definitely not supposed to drink in the VIP lounge. And she grabs the thing, she grabs the mimosa back from you.
Well, I just got here. I'm not technically on duty yet. Not until tomorrow. So, but anyways, don't worry about it. And I'm just going to push past and...
Hey. And she kind of goes, she kind of goes and sort of grabs your shoulder. And just goes, you're not supposed to be here in the VIP lounge unless you're working. You are not working.
Did I say that I worked here? What I meant is that I will work here, but also I am a VIP, and I want to pull out... Okay, I don't know if this is how this works, but can this lie to an object and a place be... Can I lie to myself and pull out a VIP badge?
You can't lie to yourself.
Can you lie to like a napkin or something? Be like, this napkin is a VIP card?
Can I lie to something that I have and turn it into a VIP badge?
Or not something, it can't be something on your person. You can grab something out of the place, though.
Okay. I let me look around real quick. What's the... this person's carrying a tray of drinks. Do they also have... napkins on there?
Yeah.
This is my VIP badge.
All right. There's just this moment where she looks. I'm going to throw a twist down.
No.
And she just goes, we'll see kind of how well this works here in a moment. Or rather, as far as stress goes. She goes, that's funny. I'm in charge of the VIP area. I would have remembered if your badge. And then she just kind of looks at it. It's like, what the hell? What do you say?
Yes, and now you're accosting a VIP. This looks very bad for you, yes?
A VIP who works here?
I will work here tomorrow. It's complicated. Don't worry about it.
I'm going to go, since you started with your working here and then the VIP, which does seem to kind of clash, you kind of pulled it off her tray. I'm going to go with a hard on this one. So you're looking at a 5 or a 6 for the almost.
Fair. Fair. I should have made up my lie before I... All right. What do I have to... Is this... Would this be deception? Or would this... I think well...
the deception works here.
Okay. So that's a D8. Well, it's not a D8. I didn't roll an 8.
From the stress, go ahead and take an injury.
Okay. I'm going to shrug it off.
Yeah. There's just this moment. She goes, just, and then she kind of like throws it back at you, kind of pissed. He goes, yeah, well, enjoy your time in the VIP lounge.
Thank you.
Head straight back into the, like the kitchen.
Very combative, the help here. I don't understand.
Yeah, they're all like that, kid. I don't know why I got Nessa disease.
Sorry.
I don't know why I got Nessa disease. They're all like that, kid. There's kind of an older woman.
Don't change it to Nessa disease. It's only today.
Yeah. An older woman just sort of looks up because she's sort of nearby. Goes, service here has been crap. It's been terrible. I don't even know why we booked this stupid trip.
Yes, I understand why you're frustrated. It seems like they're just not performing good service. I'm not sure what's going on.
And there's this moment she just kind of looks up at you and goes, want to take a seat?
Yes, thank you. I will gladly take a seat. And in fact, I'm going to grab... did she take the tray with her to the kitchen?
Yeah. But there's other people walking around.
Yeah, I'll grab another drink and be like, give that to the old woman and be like, hey, please have a drink with me. Unfortunately, the help took mine. I'm not sure that I didn't know they could do that, but...
He smiles and just sort of looks at you and goes... thank you for the drink. It was nice to get away from my husband for a little bit, be here on this trip by myself.
Oh, your husband, huh? And not a fan of the open ocean?
Not a fan in general. Up at the captain's. Yeah, so like as it kind of goes up, there are no one right now is like kind of guarding anything, but you've got the people on the bridge up there. Do you just walk in, or what do you do?
I confidently walk in like I belong there. Don't really say anything. I got a suit on, just kind of like walk in, just stand around, looking for the manifest, like if it's laying there anywhere or anything like that. Just trying to look as non out of place as possible.
Okay. Yeah, as you're up there, there's just someone looks over and just goes, excuse me, can we help you?
Oh, I'm one of the new employees. I start tomorrow. I'm just kind of getting a scope of the building or scope of the ship.
What are you going to be doing on the ship?
They have not told me yet.
So you're here, but you don't know where you're going to be.
Yeah, nobody. They just said get on a boat, fly to the or get to the other boat, and they'll direct you when you get there. What was his name? Ahmed?
Hakim.
Hakim. Hakim gave us our rooms and said he would direct us tomorrow. So I was just getting my bearings and thought I'd meet some of the crew.
Yeah, generally, we don't have people on the bridge unless you're part of bridge crew. You do kind of spy like a clipboard that's got like a bunch of like a good stack of papers on it. It looks like it's probably the manifest.
Okay. So I'm the schemer, so I lie to people, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's all right. I'm gonna say, how do I want to word this? I'm gonna be like, I'm sorry, I was unaware of that. I just need to grab that clipboard and take it to Hakim.
Like this one might just be a deception. Do you want to make it a lie on there?
Yeah, I was gonna make it a lie.
Okay,
because like I can manipulate people.
Yeah. So I think on that one, that will be average.
Average, which is
so, I think there you're looking at a 3 to 4, as the hurdle.
All right, and I have an injury, so I roll an injury die with it too, correct?
Yep.
Okay, so I'm going to use deception as my skill for that, which I have a D8. So we're going to go D8 injury die.
Yeah, there's just this moment. He just kind of like passes over and goes, yeah, here. And then just kind of, and then hands you, and you see like there's a bunch of printouts that have got like all the people on it. It's got a whole bunch of other information on there. Some of it's sort of handwritten. And goes, yeah, go ahead, take this down to Hakeem.
Thank you. You have a good night. And I just walk out with the clipboard in hand, like kind of tuck it under my suit coat and just keep walking.
All right, Nessa, what are you doing?
I am gonna walk back in, and I have to assume there's some kind of like bar itinerary.
As far as like when the specials and such are?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's written up on the thing so people can easily see it when they go past.
I'm going to go back and not only have it changed on the sign, but have like the manager's idea or like whatever was handed to the manager changed. It's heartbreak hour, half off if you can prove you recently went through a breakup.
Have you ever seen Almost Maine?
No.
Okay. It's a show where at one point, because it's very whimsical, but there's someone who is having a scene with someone he'd broken up with, and she's wearing, so it's like, so there's a special if you're sad, free beer if you're sad. Just gotta tell me if you're sad. Yeah, we'll if you're using this as a lie, we'll go with average on there, 3 to 4.
Okay, and it's this also a deception?
Mm-hmm.
All right, that. Come on!
Jesus, you've not had much. Another one, guys, it's just kind of hitting you hard. All right.
Can I do one? I'm doing not letting that happen. Reroll an action and boost the die.
Boost the die means it goes up to the next level. Yeah, I think for this one you probably don't have any equipment or anything that would help you, but which you can make you roll twice. But yeah, I would just go ahead, reroll the die and take that up to a D12.
I have a D12 on my list, so I think I might have to do this by hand.
Yeah, I forgot to put a D12 on there. All right, there's now a D12 in there.
Thank
you.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, that's better. And I have several injury dice, so I have to roll one of those now, right?
Yeah, I think you got two. Just roll, hit it twice. All right.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, so you said you basically pull that out of a thing where here's the how it's changed.
Yep. Okay. Just like I think as I'm smoking, I'm just like,
all right, what do you do with it?
Timeline changing. I make it so that we're having the heartbreak hour and that specifically the new guy is in charge of it. So I walk back up to the general manager as I'm assuming he's still being screamed at by that lady. And I'm just like,
at this point, she's headed back to her room and he's just sitting there picking stuff up and fuming.
And I say, howdy, gent. Singular gentleman. It's me, Drick. I don't know if you saw on the schedule, I'm in charge of the new heartbreak hour.
And just kind of looks up at you and goes, what the, takes it and goes, oh, yeah. Dinner service is about to end, we'll get stuff kind of cleared out. We got the bar, we'll get the bar and such going.
All right, and I think if there's knowing these ships, there's probably like a PA system, probably not for the whole ship, but just for like the general area, you know, to let people know like bingo's happening, get out of the pool.
Yeah. No pool while bingo's happening.
No pool while bingo's happening. Get yourselves in here.
Were you placing Giotto in charge of that?
No, I think I'm going to be in charge of it. Okay. I'm going to tell him to start getting set up at the bar. And I'm going to say, Jackson James, Hoods and Hoofers, get on down to the bar area for our new heartbreak hour. Half off if you can prove you recently went through a breakup.
At which point she just looks over at Voltica and goes, "Oh, it's a shame it didn't catch me a little bit earlier." Or though it's a shame this didn't happen in a week from now.
Oh,
she's getting worse.
Are you planning on breaking up? Interesting.
I don't think I'll be staying with my husband for too long. And then just sort of takes a look over at you and goes, "Are you with anybody while you're on the ship?"
No, I find that being on ships is a good time to be unattached.
I agree. And,
whatever's happening there is happening.
All right, and, Kivara, where are you headed?
I think I'm headed to just somewhere. I'm going somewhere where I can look at the manifest.
Okay.
And see if, like, anybody's here alone.
All right, as you go through, there's several sort of people that are there alone. You notice a couple things. I mean, one of the things you're going to get is Rosemary Thompson, who turns out to be the VIP that right now is talking with Voltica. You also see there's, for one of the rooms of the staff, there's a thing crossed out, and then another room, like, right next to where the three of you were. A handwritten in, Giotto Vacci had just moved out of the room that he was in with Aaliyah Burns. And this looks like this has happened recently.
Okay. I'm gonna... What?
It's nice that they let potentially romantic employees be in the same room. That's kind of fun. This is a very open cruise ship environment.
And what were those names again?
It is Giotto Vacci, is the one who got moved, and Aaliyah Burns was in that room.
Is she still in that room?
Yep. And this is down the staff level.
I'm going to head to that room.
Okay.
Yeah.
You're heading down to the room. What's going on right now with Voltica and Voltica and Drix?
I mean, Voltica, do you want to go to you and Rosemary? You guys seem to be hitting it off. Or are we meeting on the Sun Deck?
Yeah, I mean, if it's time to meet up, I'm going to like take a napkin and write down a room that I... Okay. In the tour earlier, Hakeem kind of mentioned that there were a bunch of rooms that were empty because they didn't take on enough crew. Mm-hmm. Can I just point to a room and not the room that we're staying in and be like, if you want to meet me here later on, we can see if this is anything between us.
Just kind of smiles and goes, "Think that might be fun.
But for now, I must have a prior engagement to get to. I will see you later." I'm gonna get up, straighten up my jacket, and head on down to the meeting.
Okay. We have all three, because especially since we're a little bit low on time. Have all three of you meet before you head down to the thing? Right, so the stuff is getting set up, and people are going to change. You see people kind of heading places to go and change, and some of them are going to make their way back up to the Heartbreak Bar.
I'm imagining I'm just there, swinging oldies, sad music.
Okay. We'll see when we get the three of you together.
Yep.
Yeah.
I think this is one that the 2.5 hours that we normally play. This one probably does better at 3 to 4, just for time, for pacing purposes. Because we're getting kind of close to what will be third act, just because of time. Or this would be a 2-shot, but we got people back next week. We'll get the three of you together.
Yep.
I'm gonna refill my drink. I'll be listening. You can talk about what you're doing next.
So any leads?
I got the manifest.
Manifest. Okay. What we got here?
Wonderful, Kiva. I'm stuck in a real struggle buggy. Stalled upchuck.
No one knows what the struggle buggy is. I don't. Do you know what a struggle buggy is?
No. Backseat of... I have no clue.
Backseat of a car. Parents' worst nightmare.
You could just say that. Though I knew all of those words that time.
So the room right next to our three rooms had a couple in it that worked here, and now there's only one person there, and it's Aaliyah is there by herself, and the other person was either removed entirely or moved to another room.
Was it Gerald Vachia?
Yep, you recognize the name.
It's Gerald Vachia. He and I had a ciggy earlier.
Oh,
we all know what a ciggy is, right?
Well, see, that wouldn't make sense. I understand what a cigarette is.
Yes, I think I'm going to try to search that room and see if there's a handwritten letter.
Fair enough. I can run back to Geravalcio while we're getting splificated and see see if he's got anything.
Mm-hmm.
I can float or I can help one of you. Is either of these more difficult? Perhaps convincing Geravalcio?
What did you do for the last 2 hours?
Oh, I flirted with an old woman.
What?
Now that's the bee's knees. Tell me more.
Old woman who is maybe getting divorced, maybe not. We'll see. Like either way, early 60s. Maritime law means it's not... there's no such thing as adultery on the high seas.
Exactly. Now it seems like you're in a struggle buggy of your own.
Again, I feel like, all right, whatever. That is a potential breakup. Is it a breakup if it's a divorce papers? I don't know. Maybe.
I think it could be the real McCoy.
I would consider myself broken up with if someone served me divorce papers.
Right. Papers have not been served yet.
But
besides, maybe you do the letter first, divorce second.
I mean, if she's here by herself, she might have written a letter to her husband. So maybe you should follow that lead.
What was her name? Rosemary was it Roseanne? Thompson. Rosemary.
And she's in a room on her own. A bigger one too. It's one of the VIP rooms.
Ah, she's in this room. Go ransack it.
I can do that. I'm a big fan of ransacking rooms.
Now, whatever you do, don't end up in the middle aisle. That means to get married.
Of the ship? Oh, I thought there was something to be worried about in the central chamber of the ship. Okay.
No, well, no, don't be some lady's rebound.
There are worse things.
I mean, it's cool to be a rebound, but you know, don't be her on paper rebound.
Ah, right. That would be problematic, especially when I leave.
Also, divorce is legal now. That's fun.
What? Oh, right. 1920s. Okay.
Technically, I was frozen in 1947, but yes.
47. Okay. I'm going to go look at the room. You need to unpack a lot of things that are different now.
Yes. I'm going to go to the room I'm looking at. You go take care of your heartbreak nonsense.
So,
well, also, maybe Geravacia might be the heartbreaker, heartbreaky, and would either be in his room or on his person.
Okay, let's stay in... We can stay in radio contact, right?
No, you don't have... was one of your things coming up? I don't think it was.
No.
Well, I think I have... Or we all have cell phone... No, service. Oh, yeah, a communicator, I think. But I don't. If they don't,
no,
have
actually,
one,
well,
that's not
well,
useful.
Your communicator is you can call each other, but it's not like the earpieces and such we kind of have for there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you can get a hold of each other. Theirs is in their body. Yours is actually like part of the wristwatch thing, as I recall.
We all have signal.
We have signal between the three of us.
Signal the app where you can where your phone works, but only within certain radius.
Sure. Okay. Well, if you find anything, call the rest.
Yeah, it uses its own signal to communicate with any location on planet or in orbit. Cannot communicate into or out of a zone of improbability.
Ooh.
I'm sorry, it's wristwatch style band and a tiny earpiece. Yeah, you are able to all be in contact.
Okay.
Okay. Well, if you find anything, ring us up. Yeah?
Okay.
All right.
Break.
Who wants? So I put a thing down for the turn. What's going to happen at this point? Everything is, all of your like stuff is going to be considered one die higher. And it is now, instead of the hurdle being two numbers, it's just going to be the higher one. So an almost is going to be like a six for hard instead of five or six.
Gotcha.
But each of your dice go up by one.
Okay.
All right, who do we want to start with?
Just we can go to Giravaccio, because I feel like that's okay. Not going to be anything, so we can just get through it quickly.
Yeah, so as you sort of head over, like the storm starts to pick up that you're coming in as it kind of comes over the ship, and currently it's like, as it's going, like the rain is kind of hitting hard. People are inside, like there's some of the, you've got some of the booths and stuff around where people can kind of sit and like the stuff is not going to fly all over the place because of the choppy waters. That stuff is places where some people are, but it's starting to get bad. Not terrible right as of yet. As you come in, you actually see Giovanni's getting some stuff set up, and you got a woman about his age who's like, Gio, no, come on, what's going on? He's like this is just, it's not a good time, Lee, okay? Just kind of like stops and just, not a good time. Of course it's not. And then, like, storms away, like, grabs some stuff and is getting some stuff set up, even though, the thing's getting bad. She's like, we're probably not even going to be able to do the heartbreak dance because of the weather as they're going.
Heartbreak is okay for any kind of weather. I'm here to help.
He looks over and goes, yeah, we're getting out what we can. We got to make sure the stuff we have is all secured.
Well, then let's get to it. While we do it, let's have a quick conversation. Gio, you goofy for anyone? Got your handcuff on?
What?
You in love? Engaged?
Oh, and his eyes kind of like flick up at Aaliyah, who's going, it's a whole thing.
Oh, some history.
Yeah, never work with the person you're dating.
Now, I can't say that I wouldn't, but for the time being, I fly single.
Yeah, just sort of looks and kind of like as he's getting stuff set up for those. You got a few people are starting to kind of make their way in. There's a point where he just sort of looks up and goes, I mean, the best things about this, I mean, as far as something like this goes, I don't even know why we put this on here. The best that happens is you've got some people who are here because they just went through a breakup or something, or got divorced, and maybe a few of them might find each other. But, like, for the most part, this is families and couples.
Yeah, I think the general manager was going through something when he came up with this idea.
But as that goes, Aaliyah kind of walks by and goes, general manager's not the only one. All right, let's go to Voltika.
Yep. Pulling up to Rosemary's room and just looking around. Clea checking the wrist, and then I'm going in.
All right. Yeah, it's locked. You do have a multi-tool though.
Oh yeah, I'll pick this.
Okay, so with a multi-tool, what happens is you get to it essentially like gives you advantage. What you would be able to do is roll twice.
Okay. I don't think I have a relevant.
If you don't have a relevant, it would normally be a D6, but it would be turned into a D8 because we're in the final act.
Okay. Here's another idea.
Mm-hmm.
Could I do a D8 turn into a D10 if I just shoulder this door down?
Okay, you want to try to break it? Yes, you could.
Yeah, with my strong?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then I'll do that. I'll just look around really quick and be like, well, we are in the final act, I believe.
Like it just without even a lot of noise. You did that real well. As you sort of hit it, and walk your way in. This is a fairly decent sized room. Granted, none of the rooms are gigantic on the cruise ship. For most people, because they're usually kind of out and about doing things throughout it. But this one is kind of luxurious. It's got like a nice view over things. Like the bed itself is fairly large. It's got like some places to sit, a table, and some other stuff. And you see, like, there's like a bunch of different suitcases and other stuff all throughout.
Hey, this woman likes her stuff. Okay. And I'm just going to start dumping everything into one central pile to sort through.
So yeah, as you start dumping it into one several pile, then there's a moment. I'm going to throw another twist card down. If this was a continuing thing, what happens is you take the cards that you play from your hand, and then the twist and turn cards that get thrown down, those are going to all get added together to be like, the more I play of those, the more XP essentially you're all getting, along with the more you play the cards you've got.
Oh, okay.
And the door was, you just hear, "Well, Tika, what the hell are you doing?"
Hey, who is this? Hey, hello.
You turn around. It is Rosemary. We're gonna head down to. Kevier now.
Okay. I am at her Aaliyah's room. First thing I do is I just knock on the door.
Nothing.
All right. I'm going to see if there's any like housekeeping or anything around, or somebody like another employee like me.
You also have those multi-tools. Yeah, if you want to find an employee. You see someone coming out of a room.
Hey, I need to get in this room. One of our passengers said they forgot something in here and asked me to come down and get it, and I've lost my access key.
Okay, and are you lying?
I'm lying.
Capital L lying.
Capital L.
Yeah, we'll say this one's average. You don't necessarily pay attention to who's in there. So it'll be a 3 or 4.
D10 and a 4. An injury. Oh,
four, technically.
God.
You'll take another injury because those always work. So you'll now have 2 injury dice when you do something. There's just a moment where like you almost feel some resistance before you kind of push it through. They just go, luckily I've got a master key here, and it's kind of goes through and opens it up.
All right. Thanks. I appreciate it. Mm-hmm. I'll see you at the Heartbreak Dance.
Okay.
And open the door and kind of just close it behind me, and I'm going to start looking for anything in the room.
Okay, so yeah, this is the one that Aaliyah's staying in. That was in like here. It looks like there's some stuff that's been taken, but it looks like not everything. Maybe of Giotto's.
Okay.
But as you're looking through, another twist. As you're kind of going through, there's just this moment where the door opens. And you see what looks to be like a masseuse slash trainer. The dude's fucking built. Kind of opens it up and goes, "Hey, Aaliyah, are you?" And then sees you there. You can see Riley Sutton on his badge, and he just looks at you and goes, "The hell are you doing in Aaliyah's room?" Back up with Drix. Yeah, as she had walked by and kind of spat out that thing, he just goes, "Oh, God damn." Did I already say like never work with your girlfriend?
Yeah.
Never work with your girlfriend. And sure as hell don't want to cruise with her and work.
I hate to see a Jack and a Jill all broken up. Now, what the hell happened between you two?
Yeah, I mean, she's beautiful, but kind of a pain in the ass. You get a wandering eye, you know how it is.
Now, are you sure those eyes were wandering? It seems like a relationship like that would be a little bit stronger to take to see.
No, we met working here and decided, oh yeah, we'll continue going, but that, you know, shine kind of falls off the apple after a bit.
Now, what makes you think her eyes were a wandering?
Hers.
Your eyes were a wandering?
I mean, she suspects you didn't know anything.
But were they? I hope to God it's Rosemary Thompson, because otherwise I feel like the ship really does deserve this breakup letter.
Huh? Yeah, it's just this moment where she just kind of goes, a lot of new people come on board. There's a lot of new fresh meat. I don't want to be stuck with the same one. A lot of people looking for romance on a ship like this. I made a mistake.
You weren't looking to be tied down?
No, I just think... I just think it didn't need to be like that. At which point, like, he gets clocked in the head with a glass bottle. Or, like, a glass mug. Just boom. Now, those things are actually probably more plastic, because they want to make sure they don't break in case things go. And just, ow! And then Aaliyah's sitting, like, across the bar. He didn't quite notice she'd come up close. Goes, what the fuck? And goes and grabs, like, a knife they use for oranges and actually, like, starts to leap over the bar towards him.
No. You already got him with a dead soldier. There ain't no need to get a knife involved.
All right. Back at the room. Yeah, you just goes...
Not my room, right? Yeah, I got no problems.
Voltika, what are you... What the hell are you doing?
Okay. Well, I fell in love with you the moment I saw you. And I'm going to try to steal a page from Drick's book.
Book is going terribly.
From the moment I saw you, you have been the apple of my eye, the moon to my sun. And I just had to know if you were really serious about leaving your husband, because I want to be your partner. I want to be with you.
So you came here and threw all my stuff on the... Like, what the
hell? I'm looking for the divorce papers to make sure that your love is true.
It just kind of looks at me, like looks back and goes, you broke the door. What the hell? I should call security.
You could call security, but the passion that I feel for you, it's real. It's so real. It's so strong. Can't you see it? Can't you feel it? And I'm going to grab her hand and put it on my heart. Be like, can't you feel the way my heart burns for you?
And she's trying to pull her hand away.
Oh, I'm not going to stop that. Yeah, but then I'm going to get down on one knee. And I'm going to turn one of the, I don't know, maybe like a sock that I threw out of her laundry into, I'm going to say, this is a wedding ring. It was my grandmother's, and it's always been in our family from the old country. Don't ask which one. I don't know. From an old country. And I would be so happy if you would make me the... Mixter Rosemary.
Okay, this is going to be ridiculous, considering how she caught you. So this is going to have a 10. I guess you're using the lying to use the thing
yes.
to like create the ring.
Yeah.
I specifically said don't take any wooden nickels. This is
a wooden nickel.
This is the wooden bank. Don't take any wooden nickels. Means don't do anything stupid.
Oh, well, I didn't see your story didn't come through. I didn't get it. You think could this be storytelling? It's all the same.
I think storytelling. That was a story,
yeah,
Michael.
Eloquence.
Storytelling is more like, this is.
Okay. I just didn't want it to be just plain old deception. I like the idea of it being eloquence better. I mean, you're my moon. You're the sun to my moon. I think that's a pretty good line. That would work on me.
Hell yeah.
I saw Game of Thrones.
Maybe not in this circumstance. Okay, so that's D10 then. Because it just gets one escalation, right?
Yep.
All right.
Unless you've got like one of your mission cards will help.
I'll use my last shrug it off.
Wait, did you have multiple shrug it off?
I got two shrug it offs.
Oh, okay.
Lucky.
Yeah.
Could have used these for y'all. Needed them for me, though.
Yeah, there's just this moment where you feel that kind of resistance on there, and you push through it normally. Like, normally you would be kind of left a little bit, like, dropped down from it. There's just a moment she's like, oh, well, Tika, this is so sudden. And she goes,
I know.
She kind of sits on the edge of the bed, sort of looking at you, and then she kind of, like, takes the ring, and she's just sort of looking at it. Back downstairs.
All right.
We're going to have to fake your death before we go back to the future.
So
I'm not that worried about it.
But basically, once it collapses, it's almost as if you were never there. The only thing that...
Oh, thank
anybody,
God.
If anybody dies...
Also, what's left of me is the ring, the heart of the ocean.
Yeah. If anybody dies, they remain dead, but all other evidence goes away.
Oh, okay.
As it's collapsed with the zone of improbability.
So you said this guy's pretty big.
Yeah.
Just kind of look
him that you're her lover.
I kind of look at him like, who am I? Who are you? What? Why? How do you have an access to? What was the guy's name? Giorgio.
You're in Aaliyah's room.
Oh, I know. I'm saying the guy, the boyfriend.
Oh,
what's his name?
Yeah, Gio's.
Why do you have access to Gio's room? Should I be worried?
He just kind of goes,
is he unfaithful?
Gio hasn't been in this room. Gio got moved.
Since when?
Why are you in Aaliyah's room?
This is Gio's room. He told me to meet him here. What? Yeah, didn't you know that, like...
Make it deceptional. Let's see if this goes... I think the way this is set up, I think we're going to go average on here, so you're looking at a 4.
This is juicy, though. You've got to admit, Michael.
The D10.
Not hugely hard. Because he didn't do is go, we're at the same... Yeah, there's just this moment. He just goes... He just sort of looks up and goes, no, Gio wouldn't have sent you here. And as he comes forward, and then just cracks you across the jaw. We're going to resist an injury here. It's just going to be an average again, a 4.
And I'm resisting with what?
If you don't have anything that works for it, it would be, in this case, it would be from a D6 to a D8.
I'm unhealthy, so that's a D6.
It'll be a D6.
And do I roll my 2 injuries with that as well?
Yep.
Notice the acrobat count here.
Oh, God. All right.
He's punching.
Take another injury. And as you boom, kind of like hit the ground. Drix, you've got a woman with a knife kind of heading like over the top of the bar.
I think I'm just rushing her and like trying to be like, you already got him with that dead soldier. Ain't no need to get a knife involved.
And she just goes, no. I knew he was unfaithful. I knew that everything he said, no, I can't let him go. Make a roll to see if you can get her to persuade her. I'm going to say in this one, particularly because it's going against the zone itself, this is going to be very hard. You got an 8 that you're looking at.
Okay. Well, we all know that I've been rolling real well tonight.
Jesus Christ.
See, Michael, you know, when Meryl rolls good every single time and you're like, Nessa must be cheating or something, or God loves her, they all come out here.
All right.
They all
you spent
come
all
out
your good.
Here.
And a moment
you spent
later,
all of your good.
There's a knife in your shoulder.
Oh!
Voltika. I really don't
you
know.
You dumb broad.
Yeah, you'll have another injury. Or no, sorry. Roll to see if you don't get an injury, in which case it'll be, this will also be a 6.
Alright, well, I already, I'm pretty sure I have an injury.
Yeah.
That's a 3, but I have an injury.
You take another one. Voltika.
Yeah. As we cut back, I'm slowly, like, placing the ring on her finger. A perfect fit. It must be fate.
Just a little time.
Well, Tika, I'm so invested in this.
This is beautiful. And then she, like, while you're down there, she, like, kneels down and, like, the kiss is strong and the hands are grabby.
I'm going whole hog. Okay. I'm not shying away. But I am sort of, like, still eyeing around the room to see if I did uncover any papers. Any
There are some papers that fell out of one of the things that you upended. They look official. They actually, you can see, there's tabs in several of them.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps of the place where someone might supposed to go through an initial.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Those are like a little bit away from me, just like in that central pile. Okay. I'm going to try to like push her over, like, you know, like try to walk her over there as we're still just deeply embroiled in this kiss. And then I'm going to dip her as I grab those papers and put them into my jacket.
Oh, Valtika.
Oh god.
As you dip her.
Do I have to roll to dip successfully?
Nope.
I think I'm strong.
I will not stand in the way of someone being dipped.
Also, I do imagine, I know you're non-binary, but I did just imagine you as like a little boy toy kind of situation.
Yeah, like kind of
a Dave Fatale.
Yeah, kinda like a waspy waist-ish, you know, like long, you know, like people who are just long.
Yeah, exactly.
And when you grab it, you can feel just sort of a thrumming from it. This is the key object.
Excellent. Do I know what I need to do? Get them?
The thing is, you need to get it, and you need to get it out of the zone. Remember, you're about a mile, like the zone itself goes for about a mile. You got to get it, you got to get out.
Okay.
Downstairs.
Of this makeout sesh.
You've just been punched.
Now, Michael, my question is, they put her... No, I got stabbed, didn't I?
No.
Oh, no, you got punched.
Downstairs, you got punched.
Sorry.
Oh. I just kind of, like, roll over onto my back. I look at the guy, I'm like, really? We're going to punching right out the gate?
Why are you in Aaliyah's room? She with you too?
No. I think at this point, Kavar just goes into like a full blown truth spiel. It's like, listen, I'm from the future. I was sent here to find a handwritten letter from somebody who just went through a breakup to save the world from imploding on itself. Aaliyah just broke up with her boyfriend. I'm looking for a handwritten note. I know this sounds absolutely nuts, but that's the truth of why I'm in here.
With your charming and your storytelling, I think that will allow you to roll two of the dice and then take the higher of them.
So 2d10 plus my 3 injuries.
Yep.
Oh. Jesus!
Beautiful.
Well, at least nothing came of the injuries.
Yeah, there's just this moment goes from the future, what the fuck, goes and just grabs you by the collar and is starting to drag you out of the room. It's like, no, Aaliyah's gonna, like, I was supposed to see Aaliyah tonight. I don't know who the hell you are or why you were there. We're gonna figure this out, and starts dragging you up the hallway. Cut to the where the you got stabbed.
Oh. Oh. Horse feathers. I'm sorry about the language.
Yes. At which point Gio kind of like jumps up and grabs her, and she's like sort of screaming, "How dare you? How dare you? I know you cheated on me." Just like she's like pelting him with is this the point where I don't know if you say anything, Valtika, to everybody else on their earpieces?
Yeah, I think I'm whispering. I don't know, like, how simultaneous this is all happening. If this is perfectly simultaneous or not. Okay, cool. I'm whispering into the earpiece.
Now I'm that I've got it. You.
Yeah, God. Now that I've got you, the world is my oyster. I'm hoping they're picking up on that.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna do that, but also I will, Michael, I'd love to hear when Michael comes back. No, I'm gonna grab the two of them and say, look, I'm not just here because the corporate wanted to do a heartbreak night. I'm actually was sent by both of your parents. I'm a private investigator, and I'm here to tell it's fortuitous that you two broke up already, because I'm here to tell you that you're actually half siblings. I'm hoping this will just shock them out of trying to kill each other.
Okay, is this a lie that you're using, or is this a?
I'm not trying to make it true, but I am trying to like.
It would make it true. Yeah, I don't know. Are you just using deception?
Yeah, I'm just using deception.
Are you actually like? But you can only go back about a day, so that wouldn't.
You can't rewrite their whole history.
You wouldn't
history.
Be able to actually make them brother and sister. Yeah.
Can I go back a day and make fake sheets that say that they're a DNA match?
Yeah, I think you could. It's in time. Like, yeah, you'd be able to like pull them off like out of something.
This is a normal solution. All right, what would that be now? Just a d10.
Well, this it seems like if you show your deception, which is very good, it'll actually go up in parts of d12. I think you're just looking at a hard, because at the very least, that's going to stop them fighting. What the fuck is happening with your rolls?
Oh my god!
is there like something wrong with mine?
No, everybody's have been terrible today.
I got 110, and it was to bust out a door. I didn't actually need that.
Take another injury. Jesus Christ. Your rolls have been awful.
I just have two right now.
Yeah, as you go, thing is, that lies always work. Oh, wait, no,
yeah, I know. Can I use I'm better than you think?
Yeah, what's that do?
It turns any failure into an almost or an almost into a success. So
yeah, so we'll say it turns into an almost. Therefore, there's just this moment where they both just kind of stop and look at you. And actually, there is no almost with a lie. It turns into a success.
Okay. Yeah, I just wanted to be with some vavash, you know?
There's just this moment. Yeah, so basically it'll mean you don't take an extra injury there. They did just kind of stop and go... We're what?
You're half siblings. Aaliyah, your parents never told you, but you were conceived through in vitro fertilization. And they told. Now, see, you can tell I'm serious because I dropped my stupid accent.
I follow someone on TikTok that says a lot of those are done by the same person. But he just goes, I was also in vitro.
Yes, and unfortunately, your donor was the same. There's an ongoing lawsuit. There was some doctor who impregnated a bunch of people without their consent, and you two are half siblings.
They're sort of on the ground there. They're just staring at each other. And goes, but we've done a lot. cut back to Kavara. You're being dragged through the hall.
All right. All right, here we go.
Worst thing I've ever done in the game.
Oh, I'm trying to think of any big L lie I could tell this guy, but I think I'm just like, dude, I don't know.
You can tell him you're his half brother.
I'm like,
well.
I'm just going to let him drag me all the way to wherever Aaliyah is. I'm not saying a word.
Okay. Yeah, as you just come in, about that point, the door is going to burst open upstairs at the Heartbreak Lounge. And then what is happening with Voltika?
I don't think, well, I don't want to be blue, but I need a way out of this situation. Is there any way that... Miss Rosemary might have fallen asleep at this point.
I will say she's not asleep, but the thing is like, you know, if you need to like take off quickly, like, because time-wise, like from what you can hear from the other ones, stuff's a little desperate.
Yeah, okay, stuff's desperate. All right. I'm going to...
If we fade to black for a while, then it would be like, what happened? Well, they both like... it'd be all that stuff going on.
If I don't have the time... then I don't want to do that. I think what I would say is, why don't you freshen up for a moment, and I will get comfortable, and then we can carry on.
Yeah, she just kind of gets up and is like, goes, I think the storm's going to help. And then she's, as it kind of hits, and then she like makes her way into the bathroom.
Yeah, I've got the papers in tow. I am sprinting out of there. I'm going to, I'm not even, I don't have time for a letter. I don't know what I would say in a letter. It doesn't matter.
As you
from the future, and you're not going to remember this in 30 minutes.
As you head down the steps, you see Kavir being like dragged into the variety restaurant. But it looks like a masseuse.
This is a problem. Okay, I'm sprinting down the hall in the direction. Right?
I look beat up too.
Yeah, you look bad. You look rough. Beat up, but as you head in, Drix looks stabbed. Got like blood coming down from the shoulder.
Okay, and to be fair, I look better than the other two people.
Yeah, the other two people are both like kind of like on the ground, just sort of staring at each other. And then you just hear the guy go, "I'm gonna be sick."
Okay, this is going very well. All right, you masseuse, I'm going to hit you very much with these sticks now.
Yeah, it sort of turns. He goes, wait, what?
Please unhand our friend.
You're gonna be kind of surprising him, and I think you've also got unarmed combat. So yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I do.
Go ahead, do unarmed combat, and I think with strong as well, you'll be able to roll twice. I think this is gonna be a hard, so a six.
Okay. So I'm going to roll. I mean, these are both D8, so it doesn't matter. I just roll a D8 twice.
What? You can't...
Michael, this module is cursed. Are you sure?
Hold on.
Roll again. What is happening with the dice tonight? The amount of what?
Whoa!
Do you have a D8 near you?
I do, actually.
Fuck, we'll just have people roll, like, the dice themselves, like, feel like I've heard roll 20 feels cursed sometimes, but this is fucking ridiculous.
That's really bad.
If I rolled that many ones in a row, unless it was on, like, a D3 or something, I would be I'm gonna put these in the microwave.
Yeah, these feel off. If you want to roll actual physical dice, feel free. We're almost done.
Yeah, I still didn't hit it. That's only a 5.
All right. Yeah, so he actually just goes, he goes, Krav Maga, motherfucker, and then goes to kick.
Can I low blow him from behind?
Well, first we'll have Voltika. You'll also be able to roll twice on this as he's trying to hurt you. You're going to see about resisting injury.
With my strong?
Because of strong and unarmed combat, you'll be able to roll twice. This is just a 4.
Oh, okay. All right, cool. Oh, you know what? I should have been rolling a D10, right? Because we're in the final act.
Yeah. Everything's up one die.
On D10s, is the 0 the 10?
Yes.
The double 0 is the 10? Okay. Well, then that's a 10.
Yeah, just a nothing as he sort of hits you. Just absolutely nothing. I said, Kavir, you're going for the low blow?
Yeah, because he's now focused on Ibrahim. I want to just, like, from behind.
Because you're unhealthy, which won't be great, however, he's not expecting it, so it'll be average, so you've got a 4.
Okay, so I'm at a D6. Mm-hmm. All right, do I have anything? No. D6. I'm gonna roll a D6. Physical dice. Hey, that's a 4.
Better.
Alright. hits kind of it's kind of grabs him. We'll say we're right here towards the end. It at least knocks him, sort of like staggers him a little bit. What do the three of you do?
I think I'm gonna be like, hey, fella, your Jane over there seems like she's going through something.
This moment, he's like, wait, what? And she's just, and she like goes over to him and is just like grabs a hold of him and starts to cry. And then you just use your geo go, Oh, you too? I guess that's fine. Oh, God.
Now you're on the trolley. I think I grabbed the two of you and just like, let's go.
Yeah, we'll just flash the papers at them.
Okay. And then you just kind of just you get the thing out there to get the ship back on the thing and then out.
Yeah.
We'll say the seas are rough. You may have a rough time of doing it. You may end up having to take advantage of the infirmary facilities a little bit more than you planned as you go back to get back outside of a mile from it. At which case, as you sort of get out there, you can almost feel something behind you starting to change as the improbability zone starts to crumple, and then you're picked up by the Celeste and teleported back aboard.
I did better on driving as on the exit.
As we're leaving, you can ask me.
Celeste, shut up.
Yeah, as we do that, I will blow a kiss at Rosemary and be like,
You actually see her on the wait. What are you doing? It's just going as you got the divorce papers. Get out of it, and then.
Love is a battlefield, Rosemary. Never forget.
All right. And that is a truncated version of Stealing Stories for the Devil.
That was incredible. I'm going to buy this immediately.
Is wild.
I like this game.
I wish if we had more, because by the time we got going, it was about 8 o'clock. We had like an hour and a half. Where it's if we'd have had like a 3-hour thing after that, like could have developed a lot more stuff, had a lot more little things come in there. But yeah, it's got a Wilderness of Mirrors kind of feel to it, but then it's got all the other bizarre shit involved.
I really like this. It feels a lot like something like Blades in the Dark, sort of like in that kind of like way of like maybe not Blades in the Dark necessarily, but it has the feeling of prepping for missions. It's got the feeling of like the kind of swingy dice sometimes.
Yeah.
Because
it's usually
and that's
one
okay.
die, unless you have help. If someone helps you, it's one thing. Because if someone helps you, they give you one of their dice to also roll, and you take whatever's the best one.
It's one of the best heist ones I've ever done. Like, it really, like, you're on the clock, but also it flows a certain way where you really do feel like you're in a heist.
This is a good magic heist.
Yeah. I think this goes up there. I mean, for me, Leverage is the top. I think Dusk City Outlaws, I think for a heist, is probably a little bit above this. But I think this also, this does really great for, I mean, literally the improbability is like, all I had to do is key, I picked the ship. I just grabbed a map. And the key object was the breakup letter and then unusual events, people are more pro. That's literally all of the prep I had to do.
Yeah, quick and easy.
And they've got like a 10 or 12 mission campaign that actually has a whole bunch of behind the scenes stuff happening, like some stuff on the Celeste and other stuff. That's basically, but a lot of them are like, yeah, just do a mission, but involve this little thing over them. So if you're doing a bunch of these, like some of them will be on the Celeste, but some of them will be back there. You actually have like a storyline involved that you can use if you want, or you can go, yeah, fuck it, we're just gonna do this as one shots and play missions.
Hell yeah,
love it.
Sweet. You want to let people know where we can find you?
Hey, it's Nessa. I am available everywhere at Loch Nessa. LochNessa. I don't believe in ghosts, but I see a lot of them sometimes.
True. Hi, I'm Ibrahim. You can find me everywhere on the internet that matters at Cosmic_Ebe. As for things to plug, we have a exciting Kids on Bikes things coming up with Third Vault Yarn, Lola, a really cool creator, and the Kel Hop that is going to be coming out beginning not this coming Friday, but the Friday after that. That's going to be excited. That is that was a 2-shot turn 3-shot, so that's going to be a blast. Kendo is putting us through it. There's also over on the Name of Domain Twitch, please check out Gudia, which is going to be tomorrow, Monday, March 27th at 7 p.m. Eastern. That is this delightfully creepy, spooky game, and I do not want to say anything more about it. The feelings that you will feel if you watch Gudia are deep existential dread, fear, and perhaps a little bit of all of your hope being snatched away.
Nice. Yep. I am Steve.
It's been a while since you've done that.
Every time, Steve. All right, every
that's,
time.
That's why I'm last, so he can skip me.
I brought up something. I was like, oh, no, I need to get rid of that. Yeah, so sorry.
Yeah, I'm Steve. I'm the Dragon X on TikTok. Unlike Nessa, I believe in ghosts, but I rarely ever see them. You can catch me here on Sunday nights, and that's about it for now.
I'm Improv GM on Twitter, TikTok, YouTube, and etc. And I'll catch y'all later.
Bye.
Bye.